to do.
If you'd like to appear on Stars in Their Eyes, please call 0870 400 4000 and our famous doors could open for you.
On Sunfresh tablets.
This May, it's all about being united as ITV brings you an exclusive live package. The Champions League final and the FA Cup final. Newcastle and Manchester united at Wembley, live next Saturday from midday. Then, we're all united behind the dream. Bayern Munich versus Manchester United, the final of the Champions League. Live Wednesday, 26th of May, the climax to the season. United on ITV.
You'll need some special equipment for our next programme. PVC boots and a little something covered with sequins. It's the Abba Story in a moment.
Size. It's not everything. 16 valves, increased torque, stiffer suspension, firmer dampers.
Extra va-va-voom.
That's all very impressive.
But really, you ought to be seeing it in the hands of a master.
The new Renault Clio 16 valve. Size matters.
Hello. How would you describe the taste of Mars drink? Unique. Oops. Would you say Mars drink tastes really cool? How would you describe the taste? Come on, what does it taste like? Oh, Mars drink. Have you heard how good it tastes?
Wouldn't you just love to have a new free TV channel?
Yes.
A TV channel with great new programs.
This is the mix.
For your entertainment.
Wow.
For your information. For the way you live your life.
Well, dream no more. ITV2 is here.
A free new channel down your area. Call now!
Now on Central ITV, the story of a 70s supergroup, ABBA.
Everybody recognises ABBA. One of the most successful bands of all time, they are still popular 20 years after they made their fortunes by selling hundreds of millions of records. But this is the first time since they broke up in 1982 that all four have taken part in any programme together. This is their story.
It's a rich man's world.
Benny Andersson and Björn Ulvaeus were the creative force behind ABBA. It's March 1999 and they are in London to sit in on final rehearsals of a new stage musical which will incorporate more than 20 ABBA hits.
It's a rich man's world.
At its opening on April the 6th, Mamma Mia marked 25 years to the day that a strikingly dressed group, hoping for their first international hit, won the 1974 Eurovision Song Contest held in Brighton. Of course, that meant getting through the Swedish heats first.
I know for a fact that you had to sing in Swedish at the Swedish competition, obviously. But that since it was allowed to sing in English in Brighton, of course we did that. I mean, it was so self-evident that this would be a better strategy. So I remember translating it slightly different from the Swedish one and then recording it. And it sounded ever so much better than the Swedish one too.
Waterloo reached number one in the UK and even made the American charts, but the Eurovision tag would prove hard to shake off.
In 73 and 74, the Eurovision Song Contest was the only way to reach outside. We were not your typical Eurovision group. I mean, had we been British, we wouldn't have had to resort to Eurovision.
Well, first of all, it was totally different in 1974 than it is today. That's number one. And number two, it's still is very, very difficult for an artist from a small country, non-English-speaking country like Sweden, to get abroad and to get something and to get recognized.
And nobody was interested in something. I mean, a tape from Sweden goes right into the dustbin, yeah?
People tend to think that they hit with Waterloo and it was clear sailing. And from there on in, it was all hits all the time. But in fact, there was an 18-month gap